evening, ladies and gentlemen. And welcome to John Smith Square. I'm Jonathan Whaley, and I'm your host for this evening's entertainment. I know we're all very much looking forward to it. So, to begin with, please, would you give a big, rousing welcome to the Londonderry High School Concert Band. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, the Londonderry High School Concert Band. Thank you. Under the direction of Mr. Serge Bolio, Director of Bands and Assistant Band Director, Miss Emily Dawson. Thank you. Well done, band. Well done. Thank you very much. Thank you. And they entertained us with Into the Clouds by Richard L. Saucedo, Hadrian's Wall, very rousing, I thought, that was wonderful, by Robert W. Smith. And just a little reminder that Christmas has only just left us, and New Year on the way, a festive holiday celebration by Larry Neek. Excellent. Please give them another round of applause as they leave the stage. Thank you. Thank you. Wonderful. And perhaps we could ask Serge and Emily to have a little chat with us about the preparations they made to come to London. Thank you, by the way, again, band. You were excellent. Are you enjoying London?
Yeah.
Yes. Great. What's your favourite thing so far?
Probably Big Ben.
Probably Big Ben. Thank you for that. It's nice to know. And tell me, before you go, what is Big Ben?
It's like a really big clock.
It is a very big clock. She's right. But you do know that Big Ben is the bell inside the clock, not the clock itself. But you were right. You were right. Well done. In fact, it used to be called St. Stephen's Tower, but it was renamed the Queen Elizabeth Tower in honor of our late queen. There you go. So it's a musical evening and a history lesson at the same time. So, Emily, tell me, how long have the band been working on these particular pieces?
They've been working on these pieces since about mid-October. So we actually performed these pieces at our hometown winter concert for the local Londonderry, New Hampshireites. And yeah, so it's been about a month, maybe 2 months total.
Wonderful. Well, 2 months only. Well, wow, fantastic. I think that's worth another round of applause. 2 months. And Serge, tell me, is this the band's first time in London?
It is. Yeah, this is our second overseas trip. Back in 2008, we took the band to China. And so this was our first time in London.
Wonderful. Well, you're very welcome. China to London, that's quite a two different cities. But I bet your music went down there very well.
Oh yeah. Yeah, it was really hot. We went during the summer. It was right before the Olympics in 2008. We were part of the pre-Olympic festivals, and it was really great. We did a parade, we did a concert festival, so a bunch of different things. Yeah.
Wonderful. Quite an honor. Serge, Emily, thank you very, very much for joining us. And I know you're going to give us some more entertainment very shortly with when the Symphonic Band will come and join us. Thank you. Thank you very much, Serge and Emily, ladies and gentlemen. Wonderful. Great. You look like you're having fun. That's what we like. Great. Well, as I say, you're all very, very welcome here today. We have quite a concert for you. As we set up, we're going to be enjoying the Londonderry High School Symphonic Band, of course, under the direction of Serge and Emily. Emily Dawson, Serge Bolio. They are going to be playing for you the Carnegie Anthem by William Owens, Greensleeves, I think we know Greensleeves, a traditional arrangement by Alfred Reed, and Variations on a Korean Folk Song by John Barnes Chance. So that's what you're going to be entertained with next. I'm sure you all know that we have a lot of people in from the United States of America, do we? Yeah? I can't quite hear you, sorry. In from the USA? Okay. You're very welcome and to this wonderful building, and we hope you have a fantastic week staying with us and enjoying our wonderful city. For those of you who are from the UK and Europe, and I know there are many of you here, I want to tell you that while the bands are here, they don't just come and do the concerts and march in London's New Year's Day parade on January the 1st. They have a wonderful cultural and educational week here, visiting places like Oxford, Windsor, Stratford-upon-Avon, Hampton Court Palace. They see all the wonderful sights by luxury coach. So it really is, as well as a musical experience, it's a cultural and educational experience that hopefully will stay with them for the rest of their lives, with all the wonderful places they visit. So I think we look like we're getting it. We have a big scene change there, I think you'll agree. yeah, they kept on coming, those musicians. So this building, incidentally, St. John Smith Square, it has quite a history to it. It was commissioned to be built in 1710, so quite a while ago, as part of 50 new churches in London. And it was built between 1714 and 1728, so it took quite a long time to build. And back then, it was a lot of money. It was £40,875. So in today's money, about £5.5 million to build. So, and I think you'll agree, it stood the true test of time, this beautiful building. It's been lots of things in its time, a church, and now for many years, a well-established concert hall. Looks like we're getting close to our next group of performers. Is everybody enjoying being in London? Is everybody enjoying being in London? That's better. That's more like it. Okay. Seamless, absolutely seamless. Thank you. So please, would you give a massive round of applause for the Londonderry High School Symphonic Band. Thank you. We'll be right back.
see you back in 15 minutes with more wonderful music. Thank you. Welcome back. And please, could you give a great big round of applause? They've come all the way from San Jose, California. The Oak Grove and Independence All-Star Wind Ensemble. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
And their directors, Mr. Kenneth Ponticelli and Mr. Christopher Mora. Thank you, Ken. Thank you, Anne. That was terrific. Brilliant. Would you give them another round of applause as they leave the stage? Thank you. Excellent. And as they're leaving us and we prepare for our final band this evening, they played Skydance by Richard L. Saucedo, Adoration by Florence Price, Transcribed by Sheldon R. Williams, Joy Revisited by Frank Ciccelli, and that was the last piece, and Bach March by Percy Aldridge Granger, new team for New Year, arranged by Christopher Mora. Oh, there we are. Thank you. So, excellent, guys. Thank you very much for that. I say, guys, if I'm a bit over-familiar, I've actually known these two gentlemen for the best part of 25 years. Well, Ken a little less than that. But the other hat that I wear is that I have the honor and privilege of visiting a lot of these young musicians during the course of the year with various dignitaries from London and the executive director of the event to present the formal invitation. And I think you'll agree, guys, that when we travel over and meet all your students, it's quite a big deal for them, isn't it?
A big deal, very definitely, especially with the Lord Mayor of the country.
That's right, we often travel with the Lord Mayor of the City of Westminster or the former Lord Mayor or a senior patron. And it's quite an experience for the students because they suddenly get to realize, yes, we are going to London. It's not just a dream. We are being given the formal invitation, and so it's time to start fundraising. And fundraise they do. And Chris, now you have been to London how many times?
This is my seventh time.
Seventh time. Round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen. So, of course, what that means is that seven times ago, those first people who came from Oak Grove became the sort of trailblazers, the forerunners, for then the students who come after them, and word gets round and they have a great time. Isn't that right, Ken?
Yes, word does definitely get around, because the reason we are here is because of this man standing to my left. Several years ago, he came back and he said, dude, we got to get you guys to go to London. You'll have the time of your life. It's a great event, so on and so forth. And so through the graces of Mr. Moore here, he kind of passed our name on to the committee that makes the decision of who gets invited, who doesn't. And I got a phone call. And then we had a really nice dinner, and next thing you know, we were here in 2009, 2010,
yes. Great round of applause.
And one last thing. We do have a student, an alum, who came the first year we were here in 97, 98, and her son was played out with sax.
Oh, isn't that wonderful? Isn't that glorious? And also, you know, when you all watch the parade on January the 1st, which I know you will, starting at 12 noon outside the Ritz Hotel, I don't know where your grandstands are, but I know you'll be watching it. You know, the cheerleaders, just so you know, when you watch them, they actually never perform together. They learn their routines in their own bedroom, living rooms, wherever, at home, from wherever they come from, every state of the United States, pretty much. And the first time they perform together is on New Year's Day. So I think that's pretty impressive, wouldn't you say? Give them a round of applause in advance. But equally impressive, I was informed today that this group have played together, Chris, for how long?
3 hours.
3 hours. Another round of applause, please. So the two high schools, Oak Grove and Independence, are about, 15 minutes apart. But obviously with busy schedules and their different school times, they've only played for a very short space of time. So I think that deserves one final round of applause. Thank you. Thanks, Chris.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ken. Thank you, Ken Ponticelli. Chris Mora, thank you.
Yeah, what about that? And I'm very privileged to welcome these guys after all these years. And it is nice to know, we're thrilled to know, as London's New Year's Day Parade, that people want to come back. And I actually forgot to say to you that Chris has been to Paris with the band, Madrid with the band, and Rome with the band, as well as seven times to London. So quite an undertaking. Just while we set up for our final band, just a couple more things about this wonderful building that we're in. It suffered a number of quite big misfortunes. There was a major fire in 1742. In 1815, the church was struck by lightning. And early in the 20th century was the target of a suffragette bomb. We had the suffragette movement, very famously led by Emily Pankhurst. And they plotted to destroy the building, which is fairly ironic because in 1928, the funeral of Emily Pankhurst, the famous suffragette, took place in this very church. In May 41, the whole church was destroyed in the Blitz. And it was restored, it stood very dormant, but in 1969, they wanted to turn it into a car park. I kid you not. But the local resident said, no way. And so the whole building was restored and finished in 1969. It is one of the only Baroque concert halls remaining in the UK, and is very much in demand for concerts, dinners, receptions, and award ceremonies. And I'm sure you'll agree, it's a beautiful building. So, without further ado, I'd like to introduce to you, under the direction of Dr. Adam F. Brennan, the director of bands and percussion, to play for us tonight In Omnibus, Contende Pro Antissimo by Adam F. Brennan. This is a world premiere. You're going to hear, ladies and gentlemen, a world premiere. The Choral Prelude, Turn Not Thy Face by Vincent Persichetti. Marche Congress. Oh, I've been working on that. From Damnation of Faust by Hector Berlioz, arranged by Leonard B. Smith. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the Commonwealth University of Pennsylvania Mansfield Concert Wind Ensemble. Thank you. and their director, Dr. Alan F. Brennan. Thank you. I think that's what they call a big finish, Dr. Brennan. That was fabulous, rousing stuff. And we'll look forward to hearing, what are you going to play for us on New Year's Day? Wonderful. Well, we're going to look forward to that, Dr. Brennan. Thank you. And thank you, band. That was excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed this evening as much as I have presenting it to you. And I look forward to seeing you on New Year's Day, 12 noon, outside the Ritz. Enjoy the show, and Happy New Year. Thank you very much. Night-night.